design and programming agency from 94 to 1999 we sold it to Leo Burnett, the advertising group.
Yeah.
And just before we sold it, there were two really weird guys who came to us and had some stuff done from a big telco. They worked there. They were very different guys. Then they asked me to invest in their new thing, which was file sharing, something called Kazaa. Yeah, that's probably not legal. You probably just tested the network.
No, it did work.
It was very good. And then I said no to invest, but I said, well, I mean, it's pretty, it sounds cool. It was exactly the same business plan as you saw, from, as I saw 2 years later from iTunes. They had the business plan, but it was totally obstructed by lack of ability to buy content and nobody wanted to pay, blah, blah, blah. And so I did the business development for them and sold the advertising inside and did a lot of, I did a couple of companies. Some of you will remember the antivirus company called Bullguard. Mm-hmm. It was also distributed with Kazaa. There's this little bull coming up, taking care of the viruses in Kazaa. So I could use my entrepreneurial skills there, and then it became the biggest lawsuit in digital history, because we violated quite a lot of. I mean, we didn't do anything. We just made a distributed sharing network, and we didn't have any control of the content on it. But a lot of people didn't agree with us that we couldn't control it. But we let it out in virtual supernode, so we couldn't control it. And then, of course, like I think most other people, we were looking for new ideas, and then Nicholas and Yanis, who are considered the real founders, I just backed them. They came to me and asked me if we should do a Wi-Fi network. I probably remember when the Wi-Fi was a PCM CIA card.
Yeah.
To stick in, it was impossible.
Yeah.
So we thought about making a mesh network like we knew for military and stuff. We went around and pitched that, and we wanted to kind of call it Skyper. It was a lame idea. It was way too early. And then some other guys came and we started talking about making voice over IP. Found a really nice codec, a Swedish codec that we could implement and then use the peer-to-peer knowledge we had about networks. So instead of Microsoft at that time, Messenger was big. They paid $40 million a year just to run Messenger from server centers. And we could do that just from peer-to-peer technology. Without servers, actually, because we knew about how to do this infrastructure from Kazaa.
Okay.
And then, we also went around and pitched that, and everybody hated it because we were after ICQ and Messenger. Then we launched it and had 75,000 users at the end of the first day, and people were talking like crazy. The rest is history. Now I think it's 22% of all international phone calls are on Skype, and we definitely. Did a lot of fun, a good thing. It's fun to see it in all these movies. So many movies with Skype in it. That's weird when you've been part of sitting there making the logo.
Are you happy with the way Skype is processed?